takes me back to the 1950s when I used to really enjoy listening to 1950s pop. I've got a lot of CDs here which are modern collections of the old 1950s music. But there's lots of things listed on the back, but I've been searching for one particular piece for a long time and I never found it on the CD. But the other day, yeah, I came across this box set of LP records from the 1950s. And there's a separate record for every year. Yeah, this is the track I've been looking for a long time. Broken-Hearted Melody, sung by Sarah Vaughan. I remember back in those days when I first heard that on Radio Luxembourg, 208 metres medium wave. And there was a programme on there called The Capital Show. And Ray Orchard used to present that. And I really loved that piece of music. I'd actually left Plymouth by the time 1959 came along, which is the year that the particular piece of music I'm looking for was popular. I'd gone to the big city of Bristol to work on this aircraft, although it wasn't that aircraft at that time, it was the Bristol Britannia. I haven't really had a record player working in the house for a long time, but I've just fixed one up in this box room. And the particular track I wanted, I'm going to play next. Favourite paintings here on the wall and photographs, and this is one that always takes me back to when I was growing up as a teenager in the 50s. I was in Plymouth and I was always very keen on the local bus company, and this is me stood by and typical bus that was running in Plymouth in the 1950s, Guy Arab. They used to come in different forms, and these were utility buses really made pre-war. And I always used to call this the version with piggy eyes because it has small headlamps. I suppose we didn't have any cars or motorbikes in our family, so I used to get very keen on the buses that used to run around in Plymouth. Some are very smart, like the later Leylands that came in, PD1s and PD2s. But the earliest buses I noticed were these Guy Arabs. There were some earlier TD5 Leylands, but they weren't very attractive, I didn't think, but they were interesting. But the Guy Arabs, in spite of their wooden seats that they had in those times, always looked to be very strong and forceful bus, which were my favourites at the time. And one of the first things I started to collect were photographs of Plymouth Corporation buses. I ended up with three folders here of buses seen around running around Plymouth in those days. And a lot of the photographs, of course, were black and white, being as it was back in the 1950s. But the Plymouth Corporation buses ended up, in my days anyway, in this lovely red and cream. Sadly, it's no longer the livery of Plymouth Transport. But this was the ultimate as far as I was concerned. And of course, started all really with my affection for the Guy Arab. But what's this to do with the 50s music? Well, it's the sort of music I was listening to at the time, as I was very keenly watching and photographing buses. What part of the fabulous 50s? I suppose I was, you know, I'd just grown up from being a child, really. And 1950s is when I grew up. But I started to get interested in things mechanical, steam trains, with the wonderful buses that I saw running around Plymouth back in the 1950s. Yeah, some of the best things in life are good memories. And certainly all these photographs here of the early buses bring back many happy memories for me. Probably to nobody else, but even the adverts they used to have on the side were interesting, of companies that long gone. It's just flicking through that folder of my first file. I didn't, of course, take all these photographs myself, but it was possible at one time to go to classic events and buy these postcards, or these A4 print, not yet, these small prints, and there's that particular bus again. Also, and there is a similar one. But most of the Guy Arabs had larger headlamps than these, so they were rather rare. Most of these photographs, I suppose, do show that version. There's one with the larger headlamps, and another. This was a Guy that was eventually updated. It had softer seats and a bit more smoothing around the windows. And they ran in Plymouth for a while as well, after the original Guy Arabs. Well, that's an early Leyland. Yeah, and they were the similar sort of body. But these were the TD5s. Very unusual way that the destination blinds were spelt out. They actually had destination blinds on all four corners, which was great. You couldn't miss a bus by not showing which one it was. Front and back, both sides had numbers on. Yeah, just flicking through these things really takes me back. Well, back to that, I'm going to go to that 1938. Before I was even born, that one was running around. 37. Some of the early destination blinds were just a big black square. Yeah. Anyway, I could go on looking at buses for hours. I expect you've seen enough.